In this video, we are resuming our previous lecture. So let us discuss this dynamic loading. Dynamic loading means, let us suppose we always write a program and the program used to get divided into multiple modules. So when the program will be in execution, then the program must be loaded in the computer's memory. We know this fact. Should I load all the modules prior? Should I load all the modules in advance before being called? Dynamic loading says that load the main module at first and load other modules when they will be asked for. So that is your dynamic loading. So that means all the modules will not get jumbled up in the memory, which may or may not get the execution in near future. So why should I load them? Let them be asked for, and if they have been asked, then they will get loaded into the memory in a dynamic way, not in the static way. So that is known as the dynamic binding. In case of dynamic linking, let us suppose that is a particular module. The module has called different functions. You know functions? The module has called different functions, and all those functions are, the function bodies are written in the system libraries. Okay, done. So that is a particular module. The module has called different functions, and the function bodies are written in some system libraries. So when the respective function will be called, if then only the respective library routine comes into the memory, gets loaded in the memory to provide the body of the function, then that is known as the dynamic linking. So the libraries are not getting loaded into the memory in prior until and unless the modules are executing any function whose body is residing in that corresponding library routine, then only it will get loaded in the computer's memory. And that is a particular segment, that is a particular code known as stub, STUB. It is known as stub, which will hold that record information that this particular function is having its body in which library routine, and where does this library routine is located on the secondary storage. So it will have that information, piece of information, which will be kept in the stub. So as a result of that, at first the module will get loaded. You know, the module will have different conditional statements. If the condition is true, then call function 1, else call function 2. Then why should I load the function 1 and function 2 bodies, library routines in prior? I don't know which condition is going to get satisfied or is getting false. So depending upon the condition execution, then respectively either function 1's library routine will get loaded or function 2's library routine will get loaded. So that is known as the dynamic linking. Which library function is getting loaded, that will be decided by along with the execution. Overlays. Okay, whenever a assembly language program gets executed, then assembler comes into the play. An assembler assembles or compiles or translates that program in two phases, phase 1 and phase 2. Let us suppose phase 1, that very code which is residing in the assembler software, is taking 60 KB of the computer's memory. Pass 1 is taking 60 KB in the computer's memory. Pass 2 is taking 75 KB in the computer's memory. Done. Symbol table, where it has kept the trace of different literals, different variables, different labels written in the code, in the source program. So for the symbol table, it is occupying 20 kilobytes of memory space. Done. And there are some common routines which will be accessed by pass 1 and pass 2 both, then it will take 35 K. And obviously pass 1 will execute at first, then pass 1 will have no role, then pass 2 will get executed next, then pass 1 will have no role, and when the pass 1 was executing, then pass 2 was having no role. So at first pass 1 will get executed, then pass 2 will get executed next. So if I execute this particular program, how much memory space we are expecting or we are requiring? 35 plus 75, 110 plus 80, 190. So 190 is the total memory space we are requiring. But let us suppose we are having, say, 190K, rather I should write. Okay. Now, let us suppose we are having, say free memory space of 150K of memory space. Let us suppose I am having a memory space of 150K. Okay, 150 KB of memory space we are having. So, can I compile this program? Obviously not. Due to the lack of memory space, how can I load all these modules? Now, the question is that, should I load all the modules at the same time? Is it necessary? No. More pass 1 and pass 2 are mutually exclusive. When pass 1 was executing, pass 2 is not executing. When pass 2 will be executing, then pass 1 should not be existing in the memory because it is of no use. Who will decide all this stuff? The overlays. Overlay is another routine which will occupy another 10K. So now you see the symbol table which will be referred by pass 1 and pass 2 both will be staying in the memory throughout 20K. I think symbol table is 20K. Yes, I have written right. Common routines which are required by pass 1 and pass 2 both. How many bytes? 35K. Did I write the same? Yes, 35K. I have written correct. And overlay drivers is 10K. And then either pass 1 will come or pass 2 will come. Okay. So, how much memory space does it require? Here I am getting 20 plus 10, 30 plus 35, 65K. Here I am getting 65K. So, either I require the memory space of 65K plus 60K. What is that? Tell me. 125K, which is quite well within 150K. Otherwise, 65K or pass 2, that is 75K. What is that? That is 140K. And that is also quite well within 150K. So, now see, without the absence of overlay, I was demanding 190K. But overlay will decide which modules should exist in the memory simultaneously and which modules should not. So, accordingly, if they work, then I require maximum 140K of memory space and available space is 150K, the program can get assembled. So, I have discussed my compile time, load time, execution time in my earlier video, and then dynamic loading, dynamic linking and overlay in this particular video. See one thing, here this memory management chapter, we are introducing different techniques which will allow us to use our computer memory to the fullest and efficient way. We are keeping only those modules existing in the memory which are required to get executed right now. When required, then will be loaded. When the function will be called, then the function body will get loaded. So, dynamic loading, dynamic linking, overlays are playing a very vital role here. I think you are getting the logic. Please watch the next videos on memory management. Thanks for watching this one.